guys, jadi sekarang kita mau mempertemukan napkin roci dengan dumpling. Nah, kita ada nonton tutorial gitu di YouTube. Jadi caranya adalah mereka harus ketemu di tempat netral. Jadi ini sekarang kita lagi di depan rumah kompleks. Jadi kita tuh nggak boleh mempertemukan mereka di dalam rumah karena itu adalah territory-nya napkin. Nanti dia kayak gue alpha di sini, terus dia bakal gonggong dan jahat gitu loh sama dumpling. Jadi nanti guys akan keluar megang si dumpling. Lalu mereka harus kayak pelan-pelan dari jauh mendekat itu ceritanya.
Oh guys, lagi di sana tuh sama dumpling, lihat gak? Masih jauh.
Oke, jadi sekarang kita tunggu sampai dia calm down dulu. Jadi tiap kali dia stop gonggong atau tiap kali dia ngelihat dumpling terus lihat balik ke aku, itu good girl. No barking, quiet. Yeah, good girl. Napkin bad girl ya. Quiet. Dia kayak gonggongin segala hal orang lain lewat. I think we need to find like a quiet place, dude. Good. This is like freaking party spot. There's a cat there.
Even a cat is watching the show.
Okay, jadi kita pindah ke tempat yang lebih sepi biar nggak ada distraction lain. Bisik.
Hey.
Yeah.
What is stay?
Good girl. Yeah. Quiet. Yeah.
Hey. Stay.
No.
Stay.
Yes. Good girl. Good girl, Roci. Good girl. Okay, karena Roci itu lebih chill, jadinya kita kenalin si Roci dulu. Dumpling, good girl. Dumpling so chill. Look at Dumpling. Good girl, Nepo. Dude, dia gila sih.
Iya, dia terang loh.
Gila banget loh. Makanya aku sengaja yang ngendong Dumpling tuh guys, bukan aku. Wah, aku makin posesif lagi. Good girl, Napkin. Yes. Good girl, Napkin. Oke, boleh cium. No.
Hey.
Nappy, stay.
Good girl, Napkin. Yes. Good girl, quiet ya. Quiet.
Tenang sih, Tan.
Roci. I am not comfortable. Roci. I am not comfortable.
It's a cat. Buang muka, ya ampun.
Dia mau gigit.
Bisa, mau gigit ya?
Gitu. Good girl, Napkin. Yeah, bertiga. Yeah, good girl, Napkin. Jadi kita harus membiasakan Napkin untuk cium baunya dumpling. Jadi dia tuh terbiasa dulu. Yaudah yuk, taruh lantai yuk Napkinnya. Mungkin gara-gara aku lagi gendong dia, dia jadi nggak gonggong. Jadi memang ini proses yang butuh banyak banget kesabaran. Karena ini semua prosesnya kayak 15 menit ada ya dari tadi kita. 20 menit kayaknya ada. Oke, jadi sekarang kita udah di rumah dan kita masukin si Napkin dulu karena dia adalah alpha. Dan kita akan nunggu sampai si dumpling naik. Napkin, come. Napkin, come. Good girl, quiet. Good girl, quiet. Taruh di lantai, mama pegang aja dulu. Kasih pantat. Oh, gak suka pantat dia. Dia mau liatnya mata. Good girl, Napkin. Yeah, bad girl. Usually she will growl at first. And then once they know each other, they will be fine. Kayaknya boleh lepas deh. But we need to keep watching, babe. You need to body block her if she try to bully her. Cause that's what I watch in the trainer show. They can get to know each other. She's a puppy, yeah? She's a puppy. Be nice to her. They're the same size already. And Dumpling's only 2.5 months. Napkin's already 9 years old. Come. Come here. Yes, good girl. Huh? Roci. Roci teriaknya annoying sih. Ow, gitu. Don't go under the table. Dumpling just wants to play. Akhirnya Roci ada teman main bola karena biasanya si Napkin tuh mager. Tapi Roci baik banget sih. Yay!
Napkin, I finally have my own ball.
Kalian berasa gak sih selama aku videoin Napkin sama Dumpling, mereka tuh kayak sama banget, kayak gak tahu who is who gitu. Tapi nanti dumpling akan jauh lebih besar sih daripada napkin, kayak 5 kali lebih besar. Jadi akan lebih ketahuan. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Titan Tire. Danger. Suara gonggong itu adalah alasan kenapa video hari ini akan terjadi. Oke, kalian abaikan sedikit suara gonggongnya. Anyway, hari ini aku mengundang professional dog trainer dari K9 Training. Jadi dia akan datang ke rumah aku langsung dan dia akan bantu konsul dan mungkin membaca behavior anjing-anjing aku. Aku gak tahu bagaimana ini akan berjalan. Tapi intinya aku ada banyak banget pertanyaan untuk dia, karena aku sekarang ada 3 anabul. Dan sekarang dimana waktunya aku benar-benar butuh bantuan lebih. Dan aku akan nanya-nanya semua pertanyaan yang aku ada selama ini. Semoga kalian juga merasa terbantu. Whether or not you have a dog, or maybe you have a cat, or maybe you have none, but you just like looking at animals, this video is for you. Jadi buat yang belum tahu, Napkin Roci Dumpling itu sama-sama lagi lewatin potty training. Biar mereka pipis poop itu nggak sembarangan lagi. Jadi caranya adalah mereka tuh masuk ke kandang selama 2-3 jam. Lalu kita keluarin untuk mereka pipis atau poop di pad, under pad. Nah kalau misalnya mereka berhasil, kita akan lebay banget ngomongnya good girl. Good girl, such a smart girl, good girl. Baru kita keluarin lagi dari kandang. Jadi mereka akan belajar kalau misalnya mereka pipis atau poop di dalam underpad, kita akan kasih makanan treats gitu. Dan mereka juga akan dapat free time sejam. Setelah free time sejam, baru mereka masuk ke kandang lagi. Tapi kandang itu bukan tempat punishment sebenarnya. Dia tuh tempat kayak, jadi kita tuh training mereka suka crate mereka. Tapi untuk Napkin Roci yang udah umur 9, susah banget. Karena selama ini tuh mereka udah ada habit berkeliaran gitu.
So what is the good, what is the bad that you've been facing with all your dogs?
So for Dumpling, she's already quite loyal to guys and I and my mom. She follows us around.
What do you mean by loyal?
She follows us around. Tapi nggak selalu follow us around juga. Terus she doesn't bark a lot, but when she does bark, she goes into like barking fits gitu loh.
Is it anything that triggers that bark, or what does she bark at?
When she's in the crate in the beginning, she will be barking.
Now still?
Now still, yeah.
What do you guys do when she barks?
So we learned from the dog trainer Brandon McMillan itu, yeah. Katanya disuruh pakai a coin bottle, meter gitu biar dia attention-nya ke kita. Terus kita quiet gitu kan. Terus pas dia udah quiet and distracted, we give them a treat and say good girl. So we've been trying that, but
how's it going?
Hasn't been working.
Do they sleep with you or in the crate?
They used to sleep in my bed, but now they sleep in the crate. Uh-huh. Tapi my mom sometimes lets them sleep with her on her floor, the bedroom. Dumpling the crate every night in my room. If she's like, for example, in that corner, she's biting something, and then yeah. I go no, and I don't go over there, she stops. See, tapi kayak agak-agak gengsi gitu loh. Jadi kayak she will bite. Yeah. And then she hears me going no, she will kind of do this a little bit. She'll bite again. She can do this a little bit. I'm like no, and then she will walk away slowly.
So it takes several times.
It takes several times. Okay. Yeah. She drinks a lot of water, so that's why we always put her in the underpad every 30 minutes.
Okay.
Most of the time successfully. Yeah. But sometimes we put her there, she doesn't pee. We put her back in the crate, and then she pee. And she would even sometimes go into like Napkin's crate to poo. Yeah. Like while we're out here, like free time, we go in there to poo.
Okay.
And then another problem is because the other dogs have been staying in this house for like 9 years, so there's like accident spots everywhere. They all.
Ini Marma.
Marma.
No.
Because yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Cats. Yeah.
Okay. What is he eating now?
Masih kibble yang lamb.
And how's the eating?
Dia beri makanannya. She would tunggu sabar untuk makanannya. Gak sabar.
So that's the problem, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Because your other dogs are fighting over food, so yeah. I'm asking how is Dumpling doing with food.
Yeah.
Because if Dumpling is super excited, the three of them are going to fight eventually. Anything else about Dumpling? How's the grooming? Is grooming good for her?
Minum basah mau bilang pakai tisu, wah itu
problem. She hates being wiped. Yeah.
Okay. I feel like Roci is not really that problematic. She's very sweet and like she doesn't bark much in the crate. The only thing is she's jealous because, to be honest, I'm closer to Napkin. So kalau I sayang dia, Roci would get jealous. Oh, kind of push Napkin's face a little bit.
So she would actually go in between you and Napkin and shove Napkin away.
Yeah. Like for example, they're both trying to get up the sofa like this. Roci will be kind of shoving Napkin to
like to her.
Yeah, like
okay.
To her face.
Okay.
All
right. And this is with guests as well, or just humans at the house?
I think mostly humans at the house.
Atau mungkin mereka semakin tua, berubah sikapnya.
In for most cases, the older a dog is, the more laid back they are, you know, like they just, you know, the cuek. So the fact that abis a while and then tiba-tiba they start to create more problems, it's a bit odd unless there's a trigger to it. So if also, like Napkin will growl and she moves away, right? Typically.
Yes, typically.
So when a fight happens, what is the situation? Okay.
So usually when Rochi's patience will run out, usually she will look away and not want to fight. But when she gets pissed as well, she will look back at Napkin and growl at each other, growl each other, and then Napkin will do the first charge, and then will bite Rochi's face or something, and then Rochi will bite her back. She barks so much. It's the biggest problem of Napkin Z. We tried the whole quiet thing, the coin bottle thing. We tried hitting her butt. We tried teriak very loud. Kalau teriak very loud, she would get scared a little bit. She would keep quiet. It's almost like she has a barking sickness. Like,
what did she bark at?
Label. Kayak orang baru datang. She will keep barking kalau misalnya kan biasa mas-mas kan nggak mau pegang dogs kan. Nah mas-mas naik turun, she will be standing here, keep barking nonstop.
What do you do?
Try to quiet. Kalau nggak, we put her in the room.
So you actually, then she actually bark in the room?
Yeah.
Okay, so the whole time.
Yeah. Mm. Wow, how long has it been? Bisa bark nonstop for hours.
Years, doing like this.
Yeah, pretty much.
And they get up and down the couch whenever they want.
Only working it.
And you allow it.
Yeah, nggak boleh ya harusnya.
No, it's not nggak boleh. You just want to understand.
Yeah.
Know, what is it impact? What is it telling your dogs?
Yeah.
And what's telling the other dogs? Mm-hmm. So just want to know what the situation is. Oh. Intinya, you can do anything you want with your dog. There's no right or wrong. It's how you want to live your life. But you gotta understand. If I don't like this particular behavior, my dogs are fighting. Am I actually feeding them unconsciously? Mm-hmm. That's what I want to help you with. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I'm not trying to say like you cannot live this way.
Yeah, yeah.
That's not fair. I mean, these are your dogs. This is not my dog. This is your house. But you want to understand, if this is not what you want, how do you get what you want? And what you're doing that is impacting that in the end. Like for example now, the roach is only the one that gets to come up. So she's kind of like superior, right? So then whoever comes to you, she has the right to dictate, no, you cannot go to them. I can decide that. So that's why she pushes that kind of way when you touch her. That's why she decides, if I finish the food, I'm the most superior. So then she's the one that's actually becoming the one that's getting the most things done because you let this happen. Make sense? So it's not that you cannot do it, but you gotta make it, you know, on your terms, basically. Because it's impacting her in a way that she says, I decided to get close to be close with humans.
Okay, only because she's physically more able to do this.
I've seen chihuahuas jump really high. It's not about that. It's just they don't want to, or maybe she's already done it and it goes, you know what, I'm gonna do that one.
She actually can.
She can. If you train her, she can.
Go up the sofa.
Yeah. No, it's easy. Have you seen corgis jump? Corgis are even shorter and heavier, you know? So it's not that they're not bisa, she doesn't want to.
Lazy.
Or she never got trained to specifically for the muscle, right? Yeah. So I mean, a short person can do a really high jump if you train to do so. So it's not that she couldn't, she just never got the chance to train herself, or she doesn't even want to in the first place. So you look at a lot of tiny dogs, they can do a lot of different things. So it's not that this one's a bit bigger than the others, no, 100% not. So what did you really learn out of this Brandon McMillan? Why did you decide to still call us?
I mean, the video is very much for puppies.
Okay.
And when we watch it, we're like, oh, it's easy, okay. And then we do it. And then
how
like,
have you been doing it?
Udah kayak 2-3 weeks we've been trying to follow through.
So you've been doing training for 2-3 weeks out of how old are they?
9 years old.
Okay.
I know, we're not
okay. Yeah, need a lot of time.
You need a lot of patience.
Need months,
That's patience.
Kita udah kayak mental breakdown di sini, gue udah di sini.
Alright, so then, let me explain a little about training. So, usually we do home visit training, which is once a week, and then the trainer comes to your house, and then we do an hour, and then we can train whoever is involved with the dog, so including the Umba if they're involved as well, and then we give you homework every week to work off, right? Given that you have 3 dogs, it's good that you have so many people at home, so one person's in charge of your dog, and next week we do a rotation, so everybody gets to know different dogs, right? What is important is you have to do your homework because, you know, I come one hour a week, that's a very little time. So I give you as much as you need to practice in that 1 week. The more you practice your homework, the more rajin you are, the more you can learn the next training. So the progress really depends on the owner and how much effort you put in. Another thing that we can do is a sort of crash course. It's one day training when I come and I just teach you everything at one time and then you take your time to actually been practice and give it time, and then you actually continue to WhatsApp me your progress for me to help you basically through WhatsApp, and then I'll come and follow up. The last thing too is to actually do a board and training. You put the dogs with me, and then I'll train the dogs for you, and then when I send them home, you have to reinforce the training. In your situation, the biggest issue I'm hearing is potty training. So you want to do it in the house, so I don't think the board and training works because it's a whole different environment, right? For the weekly training, you have to make sure that you guys are all going to be consistent and do your part, you know? So for example, if say three of you are in charge of different dogs and then one of you train really hard, one of you don't, it's going to affect each other's training. Kind of like a group training, you know, like you say. So you're going to talk with everybody in this household that is interacting with the dog, how willing you guys are all to put in effort, because then you can have a successful training that way. All I can do is I can say, you know, this is what your dog is thinking, this is what your dog is interpreting your actions, this is what I suggest you do. How comfortable and how willing you guys are to do it is what you guys have to discuss as a family to decide what's the life you want with your dog. So, but if you're like that just now, you would just be talking through the barking.
Either that or we'll just put her down.
Oh wow! One thing, her barking is not never gonna go away, but you can control it. Because that's the type of person she is. Okay? It's for example, if a person is kagetan, she's gonna be kagetan always, but she's gonna calm down faster once you get to learn how to build a relationship with her and you become the kind, the trust of her.
But she also comes napkin.
And you guys say napkin is the alpha.
Yeah.
You don't think so?
Absolutely not.
Really?
Yeah.
What we're gonna do is that we're gonna teach you how to understand your dog. Why do I say Roji is the alpha? Number one, Roji decides who gets closer to the human. Nothing doesn't decide that. Roji gets to go up places that's higher than anybody else. Roji talks. Humping is not a sexual behavior, it's dominant behavior. And when this food, when you know she decides, I wanna get that. So on the day that she says, you know what, I am gonna decide that, then she fights. Napkin growling is not napkin salah, yeah. It's wajar, no? It's her right, you know, like, this is my food, I'm actually eating it, don't come close to me, I'm giving you a warning. That's not aggressive, that's a communication. Growling is not aggression, growling is communication.
Okay.
Oh.
One side.
Again, I don't want her to escalate in stress, I want it to be a snap and then you calm down. The reason why she even started this way is because she's grabbing for attention, and then you gave her the attention. Acknowledging her, I'm just snapping her out of it, and then she calms down. Did she be in pain? No.
Yeah.
So it doesn't
target aja dulu.
It's not about. So this is the point of your point. That's what the idea is. Target it in the sense you're getting a different sound to redirect.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you're going.
Yeah.
So you're giving her attention while redirecting. It doesn't make sense. She's confused.
Diam loh. Harus eye contact.
But not tenang.
Dia diam karena kita udah liatin dia atau apa?
Karena ada suara tadi.
Oh, coba kita cuekin lagi
like,
ya.
It's like orang yang penakut, dia bakal teriak gitu.
And then you shake her, dia gak denger.
Teriak, then you slap her. But still tegak, ngerti gak? And then lama. It's not pretty when you want to correct a dog, that's the fact. But you don't want to hurt the dog, but sometimes in order to make them relax, you gotta snap them out of it. And you gotta understand that. Some owners feel, oh, what are you doing, you know? I want to say, we never hurt the dog. But you have to do what is important rather than letting things escalate even more. Because I would say that